गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद नंबर सिस्टम फ्रॉम नाइन्थ क्लास चैप्टर वन. ओके, एज वी आर नो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस कोरोना वायरस वी आर स्टेइंग एट होम, तो लेट वी स्टार्ट सम स्टडीज एट होम. ओके एवरीवन, नंबर सिस्टम. ओके, देन व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस क्लासेस. All these definitions, the basic definitions are there. We have already studied them. Just we are going to revise them. Okay? The natural numbers, they are denoted by n. What about the natural numbers? They are just counting numbers. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on. They are not, they doesn't occur in decimal form. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on. Okay? This is called curly bracket. Curly bracket closed. Whole numbers begins from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. And so on means they are continue till infinity. Right? We can't say that this one is the last whole number. We can't say. Now bracket closed. So what we can say? We can say every natural number is whole number. True. Some facts with the help of these two definitions. Because of this year, you know, or the last year also in the exam, you know what happened? One marks question. So we have to focus on every minor thing, we have to focus. Okay, so that's why you can see now every natural number is a whole number. So one marks question, true and false, it can be in the form of fill in the blank also. So we have to read everything. Every whole number is a natural number. False. Why? Because of in whole numbers zero is there, but natural numbers begins from one. That's why every whole number is a natural number is false. But every whole number except zero is a natural number. This is true. Except 0, that means if we remove 0 from whole numbers, then it is true, right? Now integers, what about the integers? They are denoted by either I or Z. Okay, either we can begin with I or we can begin with Z, right or not? We can denote them by I or we can denote them by Z. What about the integers? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and they are also in negative, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 and so on. Okay, so what you observe here, these negative integers, they are negative integers. What about them? These are positive integers. So what about 0? 0 is called non-negative integer. Non-negative integer, neither negative nor positive. This is called non-negative integer. Okay. So what we can observe here, every natural number is an integer. Every natural number is an integer. True or false? Yes, true. Because of every natural number, we can see now all the natural numbers are present here in the set of integers. So that's why this is true. Secondly, we can say every whole number is a natural number. Every whole number is an integer. Yes. True. Every integer is a natural number. False. And the same thing, every integer is a whole number. This one is also false. Okay. Right. Now we discuss some other definitions. What about the other definitions? We know even number and odd numbers. What about even number and odd numbers? Even numbers which are divisible by 2, they are denoted by E, even numbers. What about even numbers? 0, 2, 4, 6 and so on. What about odd numbers which are not divisible by 2? 1, 3, 5, 7 and so on. Right? Now we discuss about prime numbers. What about prime numbers? Numbers which are exactly divisible by 2 numbers. What about exactly two numbers? That is 1 and itself. For example, if we talk about, for example, 2. If we observe now, 2 is divisible by 1 only and 2 is divisible by 2 only itself. What about 3? 3 is also prime. 3 is divisible by 1 and 3 is divisible by 3 only. Okay, the numbers which are divisible by exactly two numbers, they are called prime numbers. Or what we can say, the numbers which are having exactly two factors. Only two factors. So we can observe here, number 2 is having only two factors, 1 and 2. Number 3 is having only two factors, 1 and 3. So from here what we, and they are denoted by T. Okay, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11 and so on. So what we observe here, 2 is the only even prime number.
who is the only even prime number.
Okay, other than two, all the prime numbers are odd, right? Okay, everyone. Okay, now what about composite numbers? Composite numbers are those which are having more than two factors. Composite numbers. Which are having more than two factors. These are all the things you know already from in 7th standard and 8th standard you have studied everything. But just for revision, okay?
So what about composite numbers? We can say 4.
More than two factors.
One factor is 1, one factor is 2 and one factor is 4. We can say 6. What about 6? One factor is 1, one factor is 2, one factor is 3 and one factor is 6.
They are having more than two factors, okay? They are called composite numbers, right?
Now we will discuss about co-primes. Now we will discuss about co-primes.
We just observe everyone. We have written here what co-primes. That means not a single number. That means it will be there will be more than one number. So what about co-prime? In the definition of co-prime, a pair of number whose LCF, LCF you know, highest common factor. A pair of number whose LCF is 1.
For example, if I will say 2 and 3,
a pair, if I will consider a pair 2, 3,
so what about 2, 3? Its LCF is 1. So what do you mean by 1? That means 2 and 3 commonly divisible by 1 only.
If we have 2 or 3 ki baat kar rahe hain, then they are exactly divisible by 1 only. Okay?
We can take any other example, 3 and 5. What about them? They are also, between them, the common factor is only 1. There is only one common factor. Okay?
One most important thing is co-prime number. Okay? That doesn't mean that both the numbers will be prime. They can be composite also. Okay?
For example, if I will say 3 and 16. What about them? 3 is prime and 16 is composite. What about their common factor? Highest common factor? Their highest common factor is 1. Right?
So this is co-prime. So we have discussed the natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, even numbers, odd numbers, primes, composite and co-prime. Okay? Now we will begin with
rational numbers. That one also you have studied in the 8th class. Rational number. Now the question is, what is rational number?
Okay, we know it very well, the numbers which occurs in the form of P upon Q. What about P and Q?
P and Q both are integers. P and Q both are integers, but Q is not equal to 0.
That means the numerator and denominator both will be integers. Okay, if any rational number is there in rational form, in fractional form, then numerator and denominator as well as both of them will be integers. And their denominator can't be 0.
For example, you can take the example, 2 upon 3, both are integers, denominator is not equal to 0. 1 upon 5, both are integers, so minus 7 upon 6, minus 7 is integer, plus 6 is integer, and so on. Okay, so can we say 1? Is a rational number? Yes, why? Because of 1 we can write in the form of 1 upon 1. Okay, 2 can we write what? 2 upon 1. Integer upon integer, denominator is not equal to 0. Can we take 0? Everyone listen. Okay, this is also the question in your NCERT, the first question. When you will do the exercise, then you will see that this is the question. You find out 0 is a rational number or not. So what you will see? 0, can you write 0 upon 1? Is 0 in the form of P upon Q or not? Can we write 0 is equal to 0 upon 2? Can we write 0 is equal to 0 upon 3? Right? So integer upon integer, but denominator can't be 0. So what we can say, this is called rational number. Okay? But in decimal form, they are terminating, ya to ye terminating honge, or non-terminating and reoccurring. What do you mean by terminating? What do you mean by terminating? You can take now 1 upon 4 or 1 upon 2. 1 upon 2 is an example of terminating when you will divide to 2, 5 to 10, 0.5. So what about this terminating? Terminating means after decimal,
after 1 digit or after 2 digit or after 3 digit, it will stop. The remainder will come 0.
Okay. What about non-terminating? For example, 1 upon 3, if you will divide, you will find out 0.33 9, 33 9, 33 9, and so on, and so on, and so on. Or this is written as 0.3 bar. This is non-terminating and repeating. Right?
The rational numbers are which occurs in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q both are integers, but Q is not equal to 0. Or if we observe in decimal form just they are terminating. Or they are non-terminating and reoccurring. If it, they will be non-terminating, so then they must be reoccurring. Reoccurring means they will repeat after decimal. After one digit or after two digits or three, in pair they will repeat. Okay.
For example, if I will say 2.357 bar, that means 2.357, 357, and so on. In this way, they will reoccur.
Right? And rational numbers are indicated by Q.
They are denoted by Q.
Right? Thank you, everyone.